All right, everybody listening out there, we got a special guest in right now, Mr. Aaron Lee of YNT. What's up?
Hey, hey. What's up?
Man, you just come back from rehearsal. You guys are taking off on another tour, right?
Yes, sir. We're leaving on the 19th of this month to go do Western Europe and the UK. I think it's 26 shows, 27 shows, something like that. And yeah, I was just at rehearsal. We just banged out 4 hours, added some songs that we've never put in the set before. And so just for the Europe fans, and it should be cool, man. Yeah.
Cool, man. So you've been to Europe a few times. But what do you like about the European crowds, man?
The passion. It's different when it comes to music there because they're open to they don't need a cell phone in their hand the whole time. You know, they're watching the show. They're engaging the show. They're singing along and, you know, they're just having a good time and in the moment, you know, opposed to in the U.S. And I'm not, you know, downplaying it. But
no, let's downplay the U.S. a little bit.
Well, I'm just saying, you know, it's just different because everyone's so focused, hyper focused on their screen in their hand than to be in the moment. So, yeah, it's a refreshing thing to go to a country that really appreciates you and wants to be there with you.
Yeah, they just don't listen to it. I was talking to Ira Blackett. They don't just listen to it. They live it over there, the music.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so that's very cool. So let's back up a little bit, man. So where were you born and raised?
I was born in San Jose, raised in San Jose. Raised a lot of hell in San Jose.
Raised a lot of hell in San Jose. So what was the first music you heard that said, man, I like that?
Some of the first music?
Yeah.
First music... Probably, fuck, man. Oops, can I
say that's all right. We say frick, frack, fruck.
Sorry.
So, okay, what was the first music you heard that said, I want to do that, man, as in picking up a guitar or bass or whatever?
Kiss.
Kiss? They turned out a lot of people, huh?
Yeah, yeah. Kiss and you know, and YNT, honestly, really. When I became, you know, a teenager, 13, 14, I got into YNT, you know, I'm old now. I'm 50. So that was...
Man, I'm 49, so we're right up there the same kind of generation. Yeah. But YNT, do you ever thought, hey, I'm going to be playing these guys one of these days?
It did cross my mind.
When you were a kid?
Yeah. Well, because here's why.
That's very cool.
I was so into that band and in my friends in the neighborhood as well, you know, being teenagers, growing up together, learning how to play music and instruments. And and at the time, I played guitar and I was playing drums and... And but there were better guitar players in my neighborhood, and so we needed a bass player. Well, when I was listening to YNT, I could hear the bass. Phil's bass was really, really prominent in the mix. You know, you can hear his bass lines, and I thought, I want to play bass, man. I'll play bass. You guys play guitar since you play better than me right now, and so that's what how that led to that. But as I was learning how to play bass, I was learning YNT songs. That's how I learned how to play. And then it did cross my mind at one point when I was thinking, maybe Phil will not make it to a show and I'll be in the crowd.
Just in the back of your mind, just thinking stuff like that. Huh?
And then they'll need a bass player or, you know, yeah. Or like the movie Rockstar, you know, where the kid's in the crowd, you know, that kind of situation. But, I mean, honestly, man, I didn't, it just, you know, this has been such a blessing to be able to play in one of my all-time favorite bands.
Yeah, so what's your definition, say, making it? Is it the same as you thought, say, back then? Say, when I make it big, or with your idea, or your definition of it, you know?
Yeah, everyone's got their own definition.
Yeah, everybody has a different answer, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. For me, I, you know, if you could do something that you love to do and you do for free, then you've made it.
Yeah, right on. Right on. I made it, man, because I'm right here doing this for free at Ozcat Studios, man.
See, everyone's got their own definition, you know.
You know what? It just, I love sharing the music and talking to people like you. I love bringing people in the studio and talking to them about their lives. It ain't about, you know, all the glam and all that. It's just about the person, you know.
Well,
what I'm saying?
You know, I've never aspired to be like a quote-unquote rock star. That wasn't ever my gig. And in fact, the people that know me best, they know if they call me that, those are fighting words. So I just aspired to be a musician. That's really what I wanted to be, and I've become that, and I'm really proud of that fact. Took a long time, you know. I came late in the game now. I've been doing this my whole life, but to have these opportunities present themselves, you know, in the last almost, you know, 8 years. But
so would you say you've made it then, in a way?
Yeah, why not?
Right on, man. So, so have you ever had any Spinal Tap moments, man? Why don't you give us one situation on the road or something like that that things just went awry?
I've been asked that before. I haven't had a situation. Well, actually, without getting too detailed, do you have to take a break or something? Is that what you're
looking at? No, I'm just going to keep it going after we're done talking. No, we got to take a break. We got Aaron Lee in studio right here for Y&T. The Plaza don't take no breaks when he's in the studio. So
all
what's
right.
up?
Cool. I almost got murdered on the last tour. So, you know.
Really? Was that over here or over there?
It was in Texas.
In Texas?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Let's just say I was in the wrong vehicle at the wrong time and shit went crazy. That's
a moment.
And I jumped out and ran and, you know, with my bag of McDonald's.
With your bag of McDonald's?
Nothing spilled.
Nothing spilled?
Still had my Coke in hand, man, but I made it.
Every damn chicken McNugget was still in the So you got a thing called Vagabond Brothers. Are you doing an acoustical side thing or whatever? Let's talk about that.
Okay. Yeah. That's something kind of like in the late, as in the last 30 days or so. I've ceased. I put Vagabond Brothers on a indefinite hiatus, and I'm just doing solo acoustic shows now. But yeah, I was doing this thing, Vagabond Brothers, an acoustic duo that is all classic rock, all covers. But it's deeper cuts. It's not the typical stuff that you would, you know, go see a cover band do. And there's a vibe to it, you know. There's some rearranging of things. And it's just, it's entertaining. People show up. So, but I'm doing that solo now because I'm kind of tired of having, you know, having to have someone to bounce off of to check scheduling. You know how it is.
Oh,
man.
Yeah. Like co-host.
People. Yeah. Co-host.
Yeah, right? Exactly.
You're like, hey, are you busy today? Yeah. Oh, well then shit. Then I guess I can't do anything.
Yeah. Yeah. We can't go up to camstand.com studios because he's got a wedding or something like
exactly.
that. You know, a birthday party. Yeah. I know what you mean.
So I decided to just go it alone and it's been great, man. So yeah, I'm still doing that when I'm not touring and when I'm home, and yeah, it's fun.
Cool. So, does music do anything for you spiritually? Say, you know, what does music do for you spiritually? Where does it take you?
Man, you're deep.
Well, hey, that's why. Hey, the flowers, and we like to get, you know, a little, you know, in deep with our guests, man.
Man,
what is music for you? Say you're on stage. I mean, what is?
Well, you know what's great about playing music and being on stage is that I don't have to talk to anybody.
Especially like DJs doing interviews.
No, I'm just saying. Like honestly, man, it's like. It's like driving by yourself in the car, you know, and you get a lot of thinking done, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's kind of what I'm thinking while I'm playing, man. It's like, you know, oh, shit, I got to buy some inserts for my boots.
Yeah, my dad said years ago, man, you do a lot of thinking sitting on that backhoe. I run heavy equipment, right? And I've been on this job on this hillside cutting in a water slide. And all these, but it's true, man. You do a lot of thinking when you're by yourself,
yeah,
man.
It's
like your happy place. In your happy place, you do a lot of thinking.
Yeah. Yeah, it allows you to, your mind to just kind of wander and, but I also just trip on the audience too, you know, and I get off on that because, you know, if people are singing along to the songs and they're rocking out, man, they're having a great time, and you can tell they're having a great time.
You can
time.
Feel the energy off each crowd, huh?
Absolutely, man. And the thing about that is just, it's a feeding frenzy from there, you know, and it just makes for a better gig, better show, you know. But so if that's a spiritual thing, to answer your question, you know, just engaging with the audience, man, is really cool. And that's,
it is.
That's
it's
on
the
a
energy
spiritual level.
Feeling, you know, yeah, very cool.
Yeah.
So, man, what's in the future, man? And you going on this tour? So you got any of your original stuff in the studio or anything like that? Or
you mean like new music?
Yeah, new music from Aaron Lee.
Oh, for me? Well, I'm always writing stuff. But here's the thing, man. You know, hopefully Y&T is going to put out some new material sooner than later. And I just don't know when that will be since we tour so much, you know. But it's always being talked about. And so what I've got ideas and riffs and songs and things. And they're just sitting because I want to have enough to throw whenever.
So you want to incorporate some of those maybe with the new.
You never know.
You never know.
You
right?
never know. Because that's usually like the writing process would be, you know, is that you get in a room with the guys and you know, well, what do you got, man? Oh, I got this riff that goes like this. And then, you know, everyone starts kind of feeding on that. So, you know, you got to save your nuggets. You know, it's like panning for gold, you know, and then all of a sudden you get a little nugget, throw that aside. You know,
yeah,
so,
yeah.
So I'm panning all the fucking time. You know?
Very cool. So you live in Sacramento, so you mess with a lot of Sacramento bands. You know a lot of people up there, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Great Golden, man. Great Golden, the Vault. You've been in the Vault, I'm sure, a few times,
yeah.
huh?
Oh, yeah.
What's your favorite thing in there? Favorite one?
The favorite in the Vault? Well, Frank Hannon has a little case.
His own little display, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, that's cool. But just the whole vault, you know, it's
just the energy of the vault in itself.
You know, what's even better than the vault is the jam room. Have you been to the Bizarre Guitar downstairs, the jam room?
No, I've been to the jam room, in the vault and upstairs, you know.
Oh, that's cool, man. That, you know, the vault's cool, but the jam room's cooler.
Yeah, they had a jam, man. Shout out to Greg Golden up there, Bizarre Guitars and Bizarre Guns.
He's my bro, man.
Yeah, man, he's very cool, very talented. Very cool. The vault, he has like one of a kinds down there, a little bit of everything, you know. Frank Hannon has a little display there.
He's got something over like $3 million worth of vintage guitars.
You know, I found out is anything inside the glass is not for sale. Anything outside the glass is for sale.
Yeah. And there's memorabilia on the walls and stuff. It's really cool.
People that pass through. So say you want to give anything, say, to the future generation or the kids that are aspiring playing guitar or bass, anything. You want to say anything to them about, you know, about the biz or anything?
Well, the biz, the business, it sucks.
Yeah.
But, I would just say, you know, if you want to play music for a living, first off, you know, it takes a lot of hard work. You got to be a hustler. And, the thing is just don't ever be too cool or too proud to do certain things. Just do what's put in front of you with the least amount of questions, because that can lead you to the next phase of where you need to be. And just don't ever give up. I mean, if you believe in yourself, don't give up. And that's what I did, you know. But, you know, meeting the right people always is the way that you're going to make inroads in the music business. And don't be a dick.
Don't be a dick. That's right. Right there is the Plow Zone. Public service announcement with Aaron Lee right here. Don't be a dick in music. And I got a question. If vinyls, you know, vinyls are coming back a little bit, you know, vinyl records.
Oh, yeah.
If vinyl records, I mean, do you think that increased album sales if people started buying vinyls?
You know what's a trip, man, is that...
I've been thinking about that lately. I've asked a few people that.
Yeah. The physical product thing is starting to come back up in the marketplace where people are buying vinyl again. They're buying CDs again more instead of the streaming. Because let's face it, man, streaming is very useful if you want to try something on, you know, like new music. The sound quality sucks. It's terrible, you know. So to have that physical product, you know, it's going to sound better. Plus, you're not buying thin air, you know.
Yeah, like shoes. Say you don't want to go online to try on shoes, man. You want the real thing.
Well, yeah. Go to the shoe store.
Yeah, like, go to the shoe store. Exactly.
Like going to the record store, you know.
Exactly.
Unfortunately, a lot of these record stores are closing. But vinyl for me, I dig vinyl. I recollected everything I had when I was a kid. I've got probably, I don't know, maybe 300 records now. And I usually when I'm home, is that's the way I listen to music, is on vinyl. I very rarely use CDs. But and then if I want to hear something quick, or, you know, try out listening to something new, I'll stream it. And if I like it, I'll buy it, you know.
Yeah, because vinyl has its own, this certain sound you just can't duplicate that streaming, or, you know, on even on a CD.
Yeah. Well, that's, you know, hey, that's why YNT put that acoustic album together, and we put it out on vinyl. So, you know, because people gravitate to physicality and what's real these days, you know. All this buying thin air, man, is not cool, you know. What do you think?
What do I think? I think very cool. I mean, I agree with what you're saying.
All right.
Yeah. So, man, what's your favorite YNT song to jam on stage, man?
Oh, Hang 'Em High. Hang 'Em High is always fun because it's just so rocking, man. It's heavy.
Yeah, Hang 'Em High, like right here?
Yeah, play some Hang 'Em High.
You want to rock right here? Some Hang 'Em High right here?
Yeah.
Bam, let's play it here. The Plow Zone here with Aaron Lee right here. Thank you very much, my friend.
You're welcome, brother.
Stopping in. All right, man. Yeah. Here's Hang 'Em High.
Awesome.
And you're in the Plow Zone getting plowed right here. 2019, what's up? We'll be right back. Here in studio rocking the hell out, and we're talking about honey, everything sweet, just like rock and roll, right?
You got it, man.
Hey, sweet. Rock and roll is sweet and it's a little sour sometimes, but you know what, and the most of all, that's what keeps the world going around is diversity of music, man.
Absolutely, man. And honey,
and honey, you know what, what still gets me is honey's the only thing that don't spoil.
No, it
we can put
it
in a time capsule and pull it out after the zombie apocalypse. It'll still be good.
It crystallizes, so you'd need heat to reheat
probably,
it.
Yeah. Ooh, we should ask him that. Yeah. How long does it take?
What, do you got a chemist in here or something?
No, we got the beekeeper.
That's him.
Oh. He's the beekeeper. He makes it. Yeah, oh, he knows everything about bees 101 to 105. Any questions you have about honey, he is the man. Gerard Z. Honeybees, proud sponsor of the Plowsall Radio Show. We got campstand.com right there. Dave Malby, the Nutty Professor meets MacGyver. Very cool studio up in Sacramento. Thank you, Dave. He makes penny bracelets. Wait a minute. He started penny bracelets back in the, 80s? Penny bracelets. In San Jose, California, he started the penny bracelets. Very cool. And you still, I mean, still people still buy them. Because every girl I give one to, I'm all in.
All in what?
Yeah.
All in the back of a cop car. Just kidding. No, so, all right, man. You got any more YT favorites or what?
Oh, do I have any? Yeah, I've got plenty, man. Let's see. Play Breaking Away.
Breaking Away.
That's off the Mean Streak album. It's the first cut on side two of the vinyl, of course. And this is a song that I've been trying to get the band to play live, and they're not hearing me.
Really?
No.
Well, I think they should. You're the Plowzone. What's up?